Hello friends, I welcome you all on India's largest live e-learning educational platform, that is Gradeup. Namaste Vivek, Vaishnavi, good evening, how are you? Welcome to the session. All the candidates who are joining me in this session, please tell me quickly whether my audio and visual quality is okay for you so that we can proceed. Kavya, how are you? Welcome to the session. Anjali, Prem, Yashwant, Georgian, Shion, greetings, good evening, how are you? Welcome to the session. Now just quickly tell me whether my audio and visual quality is okay so that we can proceed. Okay, so friends, before I start this session, it is important that we understand what we are going to do in this particular session, what is the objective of this session, and what we are going to achieve in this particular session. Now friends, the first thing you have to understand that these sessions are a sequel. They are a sequel of startup series. We started the startup series earlier with the theoretical portion of the power system. You can understand if you have followed my lectures, you must be having this information. If you have not followed, in this today's lecture itself, I will give you the link to that particular sessions. You can follow them on the Gradeup Gate channel. They are already available in the playlist. So for the theoretical support, you can go back to those sessions if you are interested. If you are not comfortable with the theoretical concept, you can watch those sessions as far as theory portion is concerned. These startup sequel we are defining as startup 2.0. It means in this we will be focusing on problems. And with the help of problems, we will try to understand the theoretical portion. I hope you are getting my point. Everybody just tell me in the comment section, are you getting this idea or not? Are you getting this idea? Everybody just tell me. Are you getting the agenda of the session or not? That is very, very important. Unless you understand the agenda of the session, you are not going to be benefited in the best possible way. So friends, today we are going to start with the startup 2.0. We'll be trying to solve some of the problems, and with the help of problems, we will try to understand the theoretical portion. And if you want full-fledged theory, that full-fledged theory is going to be available in the Gradeup Gate YouTube channel in the playlist. These sessions are already available as the startup series. I hope you are getting this. Now friends, in this series, we'll be discussing first, we are starting with the power system, but I want three commitments from all my candidates, all my students who are watching this lecture on YouTube. You have to give me three commitments. Number one, you are going to be regular in the class. You are going to like these sessions, share these sessions with your friends and colleagues. And third one is you have to subscribe the Gradeup Gate channel, YouTube channel, if you have not subscribed, so that you get the notifications in time. That is very, very important. So all the people who have joined on the Gradeup Gate YouTube channel, if you have not liked the session, quickly like the session. And now we are going to proceed to the session. Now, before I start the session, some of you may be joining me for the first time. So let me just give you a brief introduction about myself. My name is Ashutosh Saxena. I have 10 plus years of teaching experience. I completed my M.Tech from IIT BHU in 2010. I have written a couple of books also on engineering ethics and power system. My areas of expertise are power system, electrical machines, electromagnetic field theory, material science, and engineering ethics. Now, friends, a very important information to all of you. You must be knowing this, that sometime before, very recently, we have launched the third batch for the Vision 2021 with the successful running of Vision 2 batches. And this is the last batch for the Vision, that you can understand. Just 6 months are remaining for the engineering services and gate examination, or approximately. So this is going to be the last batch. So if you are interested, if you are aiming for engineering services and gate, this is the, you can say this is the last time for you to join a course which can help you in the most holistic and, you can say, most comprehensive way. And right now we are offering the 50% discount on the MRP to all the gate qualified students, all IITs and NITs and other government engineering college students, EAC prelims qualified students. And if you have any query regarding this discount scholarship, then you can contact this number and you can write your query to this email ID, and you will be supported in all possible respect. Hello, Payal, Murli, Kavya, how are you? Welcome to the session. Now let us see who are the faculties who are going to take classes in this particular batch. Rakesh Talreja, sir, MEIST Bangalore AIR, 9, 10 plus years of teaching experience. Myself, Ashutosh Saxena, MTech, IIT, BHU, 10 plus years of experience. MN Ramesh, sir, ME Usmana University, Hyderabad, 17 plus years of experience. Vijay Bansal, sir, 19 plus years of experience. Chandan Jha, sir, MTech, IIT, Hamirpur, 9 plus years of teaching experience. So you can understand you are going to get the best of the faculties in this particular session. And if you want to experience how GradeUp is changing the life of the thousands of students, you must start the free trial. Yashwant, I think videos are already in the correct sequence. Maybe you are not finding them easily. So you better contact to the number I am showing on my screen. They are going to help you in all possible manner. Hello, Shiva, Pooja, how are you? Good evening. Welcome to the session. Now, let us see some of the important highlights of this particular course, Vision 2021 third batch. There is going to be 800 hours of live classes, 7,000 plus practice questions for GATE and ESE, study notes covering each chapter and subject in detail, full-length mock test for GATE and Engineering Services prelims, daily test and subject-wise test for GATE and ESE prelims. If you want, you can contact on this number to get any information. You can write your queries to this email ID, or you can directly contact our course manager, that is Anand Pandey at the rate gradeup.co. Prabha, how are you? Welcome to the session. Now, friends, I took this snapshot to just tell you that I have already taken the short transmission line theoretical part for Power System Part 1 in the startup series. Okay. And it is already available in the GradeUp GATE YouTube channel. If you follow on the GradeUp GATE YouTube channel, you will find these lectures available. So you can have the theoretical backup for these discussions also. Hello, Hitesh. Good evening. Tarun, how are you? Welcome to the session. Friends, now let us proceed. Now just see the first question on your screen and just tell me what is the answer to this first question, all of you, quickly. Just quickly try to solve this question and tell me what is the answer to this question. Just quickly tell me what is the answer to this question. And then we will understand some basic concepts which are required to solve questions related to these types. Shiva, Hitesh, they are saying B. What about other candidates? All the candidates on YouTube, please tell me quickly. Some people are saying C, some people are saying D. So I am getting almost all the answers. A, B, C, D, I am getting all the answers. May God forbid it is not E, F, G, H options. Otherwise, you will say those also. Okay, now just listen. First, you have to understand. Before I do this problem, first you have to understand transmission line parameters. Some details you require about the transmission line parameters to have the whole information that is required. Transmission line parameters. When you say transmission line parameters, you please understand the equivalent circuit of the transmission line you are going to represent like this. This is the equivalent circuit of the transmission line. Suppose this is the sending end and this is the sending end current. This is the receiving end voltage and this is the receiving end current. Okay. This we are defining as the resistance. This is the inductance. This is the capacitance part and this is the conductance part. Now please try to understand this resistance R represent the I square R losses in the line. This is very natural. You must understand what is the significance of these parameters. That is very, very important. Why you are using these parameters? You are using these parameters because you want to analyze your transmission line, because you want to model your transmission line. So in order to analyze and model your transmission line, you need some physical parameters, electrical parameters to represent the different phenomena. What are the different phenomena? For example, I square R losses you are going to represent with the help of resistance. What this L represents? L represents the magnetic energy stored in the line. Magnetic energy is stored in the line. What is this capacitance represent? This capacitance represent the electric field energy is stored in the line. Electric field energy is stored in the line. And what this G conductance represents? Just see here. This conductance represents the leakage current through insulator. The leakage current through insulator. Okay. Now we are saying these transmission line constants as constants. Why we are calling them constant? This is very important. We are calling them constant because if you see R, L and C, these are design parameters. These are design parameters. What is the meaning? When you say design parameters, it means the moment you design your transmission line, the moment you design your transmission line, these parameters are not going to be changed. These parameters are going to be fixed. But if you come to the conductance part, this is not constant. This is variable. Why it is variable? Because the leakage current through the insulator depends on two things. Number one, surface condition of the insulator. Surface conditions of the insulator. And the atmospheric conditions. Atmospheric conditions. So my friend, you can understand because this G is going to be a variable quantity and also it is easily neglected for our practical purposes. It is easily neglected for all practical purposes. So we are going to be only focusing on RLC. Now the point comes, if you are talking about RLC, there are two ways in which you can represent these line parameters. That is lumped parameter and another one is distributed parameter. When you are saying lumped parameter, it means you are saying it is the aggregate effect. Aggregate effect or the total effect. Aggregate effect. Or in simple language, you can say it is the total effect. If you are not getting anything, you can directly tell me. Anand Dev Banerjee, how are you? Welcome to the session. Good evening. And distributed model means you are using the line constant in terms of per unit length of the line. Per unit length of the line. All of you just tell me, are you getting this idea or not? Now, if you are talking about the short transmission line, you must be knowing this, that in case of short transmission line, the line charging current is almost zero. Line charging current is almost zero. So if line charging current is zero, the shunt capacitance is going to be neglected. The shunt capacitance. Okay, just understand. Don't give the answer right now. Just understand the concept, that is more important. This discussion is going to make you solve n number of questions just by the reference of one question, you will understand n number of questions. Shunt capacitor is going to be neglected. If somebody asks you in any interview, why you neglect the shunt capacitor in case of short transmission line? You simply say, sir, line charging current is zero. Now he will ask you why line charging current is zero. What is your answer? Can you tell me? How you are going to find the line charging current? Can you tell me? This is the voltage divided by XC. Per phase, what is XC? XC is going to be 1 upon 2 pi FC. So this is going to be V multiplied by 2 pi FC. But this C is going to be what? This C is going to be 2 pi FC per unit length. Per unit length, say C per kilometer. So you have to multiply it by length. It means you can say the charging current is going to be VFL. It means the operating voltage, frequency and the length of the transmission line. Now you are saying that the length of the short transmission line is going to be less than 80 kilometer. So for all practical purposes, because the length of the line is very small, so you can have this approximation that you can neglect the shunt capacitor and the line charging current. Now if you just tell me, are you getting this idea or not? All the candidates, tell me, are you getting this idea or not? Why we neglect the shunt capacitance in case of short transmission line? Are you getting this idea or not? This is very, very important. Is it clear? Are you getting this idea? So what is the equivalent circuit of the transmission line you are getting? The equivalent circuit of the transmission line is simply R and L, R and L. So it is nothing but the series, it is nothing but the series combination of resistance and inductance. And it is going to be what? It is going to be lumped. Both resistance and inductance, they are represented as lumped parameters. So what is your final answer now? What is the question? He is asking the series inductance and the series resistance of the short transmission line are taken as both lumped. So C is going to be the correct answer. All the candidates who are giving A, B and D, they are wrong. Janvi, please correct your answer. Still you are giving the wrong answer. After this much explanation, you are giving the wrong answer. I don't know why. All of you just tell me, are you getting this idea? Can we proceed to the next question? Definitely, Yashwant Sani, I will tell you the categorization also. Just stay connected. This is not just one day class. Okay, this class is going to run for the whole month. Okay, Monday to Friday, every evening we are having around 8. Okay, so just stay connected to this channel and you will find all the answers. Don't worry. Now let us proceed to the next question. Just tell me what is the answer to this question. I want all the candidates. I want all the candidates who are live, both on the app and the YouTube channel. Just tell me quickly what is the answer to this. What is the answer to this question? As per the voltage rating of the transmission line, how that long transmission line is going to be categorized? Everybody just tell me. Okay, we are again getting all the options, A, B, C, D, all the options we are getting. Listen. Let us try to understand. When you are saying types of transmission line, how we are going to define, this is very important to understand. We are going to define the transmission line into three parts. We are going to define the transmission line into three parts. Number one, short transmission line, medium transmission line, long transmission line. First, we are going to define with respect to the length. When the length is less than 80 kilometer, we are saying it is a short transmission line. When length is going to be 80 to 160 kilometer, then we are saying it is a medium transmission line. When we are saying length is more than 160 kilometer, then we are saying it is a long transmission line. I hope you are getting this idea. Second option, when we are saying voltage is less than 20 kilovolts, then it is a short transmission line. When we are saying the voltage is 20 kilovolts to 100 kilovolts, then it is a medium transmission line. When you are saying voltage is more than 100 kilovolts, then it is going to be categorized as long transmission line. Third point, shunt capacitor is neglected. Okay, medium transmission line, shunt capacitor is present and it is represented in lumped form. For the medium transmission line also, we are using the lumped form. In this, shunt capacitance is present in the distributed form. Whenever you are going to talk about the long transmission line, you are always going to take that distributed model. I hope you are getting this. Fourth point, charging current is neglected because shunt capacitor is neglected. Medium transmission line, charging current is present. And when you go to the long transmission line, this is one of the questions very frequently asked in the UPSC, Dolpur House, and the different prestigious institutes, IITs and ISC. IC is significant. Yes. Sheetal, you are right that conductance is also going to be present in the long transmission line, but we are generally going to be neglecting them for most of the practical purposes. We are neglecting them, okay. Fifth point, and this is all across these three types of the transmission line, if operating frequency, is very high, then irrespective of the length of the line, it is treated as distributed model, that is long transmission line. Now I want to add one important point here. Whenever you are going for a good examination means some of the prestigious examination, that is GATE, Engineering Services, big PSUs, Maharatna PSUs, and if you are going for prestigious institutions like IITs or any other place, if the data is so given in the problem that even for short transmission line, if he is giving you the capacitance, you are not going to neglect it. It is not that shunt capacitance effect is not present in case of short transmission line. It is simply because for your calculation convenience, you are assuming that the capacitance is neglected. But if the data is given in the problem, you will never ever avoid it, and you have to take it into the consideration even for the short transmission line. What I wanted to convey out of this discussion is, if you are going for short, medium and long transmission line categorization, this categorization is not rigid. It depends on the situation. That is very, very important that you have to take this thing in your mind. Now let us try to solve the question. The moment you have this information, now this problem is a cakewalk for you. So C is going to be the correct option because he is asking about the long transmission line. All of you just tell me, are you comfortable with the classification of the transmission line or not? Are you getting it or not? Tell me quickly. All the candidates who are live with me, just tell me quickly, are you getting this idea or not? Is it clear to everyone? If you have even a single doubt, you can ask me so that we can discuss upon that. I hope it is clear. Now let us proceed to the next question. Now, all of you just quickly solve this question. Just quickly solve this question and tell me what is the answer you are getting for this question. It's okay, Yashwant. It's okay. Great. Now, all the candidates, just read this question carefully and tell me what is the answer you are getting. Yes, Prabhak. Good. It's okay, Jagannath. Just now try to solve this problem and tell me what is the answer you are getting. Just quickly tell me what is the answer you are getting. Any answers? Just one candidate is answering. I don't know whether it is correct or not. tell me quickly, are you getting this or not? No answers? Okay, all of you just listen. All of you just listen. Listen. See, just read the question carefully. Hello, Jitendra. How are you? Welcome to the session. A short transmission line has the series impedance 0.1 plus J 0.2 per unit. What is the maximum positive voltage regulation at half of the load condition? The first thing you have to understand is voltage . If you are not getting, just please wait and listen to the discussion. If you are not getting the answer, no problem. Just listen to this. Listen to my discussion. How you are going to define the voltage regulation for a short transmission line? Do you remember? It is going to be R per unit cos phi R plus minus X per unit sine phi R. Venkatadri Ganta, I can understand your problem. See, first thing, let me just tell you all the candidates, if you have to go with the flow of the session, if I start catering to each and individual questions, random questions like this, it is going to be very difficult for me to conduct the session. So if you are having some personal doubts like that, why 11 kV is being stepped up? Why not other levels of voltage? You better give these questions. Go to the GridUp app. There is a dedicated section of doubt section. Write all your doubts there, whatever doubts you want. I will be more than happy to answer those doubts one by one. Okay. So please just go with the flow of the class. Otherwise, it is very difficult. Anyways, just come back to the topic. We are saying the voltage regulation is going to be represented like this. You all must be knowing this. Plus sign we are using for the lagging load condition. And negative sign we are using for the leading load condition. Everybody is knowing this. But what is the problem? The problem is, if I ask you what is the maximum value of this voltage regulation, then in per unit, it is going to be Z per unit. Are you getting this idea or not? Everybody just tell me, are you getting this idea or not? Now, let me tell you, how you are getting this expression for voltage regulation, just try to understand. We are defining the voltage regulation as I into R upon V cos phi R plus I into X upon V sine phi R. This is the equation. If you see the derivation, it is already in the previous session. It is already in the link in the playlist. You can watch that. Now, if you come to this conclusion, so you are saying this is the equation for the voltage regulation. Now, suppose you are saying I is equal to IFL. What is the meaning of this? It means you are operating the line at the full load condition. I am giving you a guru mantra. Always keep this guru mantra with you and you will be always happy when you are solving the problems of the power system. Whenever you are going to characterize the load, always characterize the load in terms of the current. When you are saying full load, it means you are drawing full load current. Always characterize the load with respect to the current. Now, if you are putting this equation, this I value here, it means you are getting the voltage regulation for the full load condition. Now, instead of full load condition, suppose you are operating at any other load condition, which is X percentage of the full load, then what you are going to write? You are going to write I as X times the full load. Are you getting this idea or not? Now, my friend, just see, if you put I is equal to X IFL in this equation, what is going to be the final answer? You will be getting voltage regulation at X times the full load is equal to X times the voltage regulation at full load condition. Are you getting this idea or not? This equation you are getting or not? Just tell me quickly yes or no in the comment section. Can you visualize this? If you put I is equal to X IFL, are you getting the X times load condition, what voltage regulation is? X times the full load voltage regulation. Are you getting this idea or not? The moment you have this equation, my friend, you can say the voltage regulation at any load, maximum value, it is going to be x times z per unit. What is z per unit? This z per unit is the maximum voltage regulation at full load condition. Are you getting this? He is saying half of the full load condition. Half of the full load condition means x value is 1 by 2. If x value is 1 by 2, can you tell me what is voltage regulation at half of the load? And that is the maximum value of this voltage regulation. Can you tell me? It is going to be 1 by 2 times z per unit. What is z per unit? It is going to be under root 2 r per unit square, x per unit square. Raj Mangal Singh Raghuvanshi, pranam. How are you? Welcome to the session. What is r per unit? R per unit is 0.1. So it is going to be 0.1 square plus 0.2 square. Just solve this equation and tell me what is the answer you are getting. All the candidates who are coming to my sessions, these sessions where we are, the objective of the session is to solve the problems. Always keep calculators with you. Wherever required, always keep the calculators, notebook, pens with you so that you can solve the problems parallelly. Okay. All the candidates, just quickly tell me what is the answer you are getting. Just do this calculation and tell me what is the answer you are getting. And whatever value you are getting, just multiply with 100 and you will get the voltage regulation in percentage. Just multiply by 100. What is value you are getting, you will be getting in percentage. So Seema Mondal is saying it is 11.18%. I hope all the candidates are getting this. Are you getting this value, everybody? Okay. Are you comfortable with this concept or not? Just tell me, this is very, very important concept. Wherever in my discussion I put 5-star, you just take a photo in your mind that this is very, very important. Are you getting this? Now let us proceed to the next question. Okay, Mukesh, you are also right. Mukesh, Janvi, Yeshwan, Dhumkar, Georgian, everybody. Right answer. Now just try to see this problem and tell me what is the answer you are getting. All of you, just see quickly and tell me what is the answer you are getting for this question. I want all the candidates to interact, to participate in this discussion. Okay. Don't become a passive learner, become an active learner. Ask whatever doubts you are having for the current topic with the flow of the class, not random doubts. Are you getting this? Just quickly tell me. Let me check how many candidates are giving the answer perfectly. Perfectly in time. Time, accuracy, both. All the candidates on who are watching this session on YouTube. See, I just want three commitments to you. Three commitments. You have to be regular in the class. You have to like and share this video. And you have to subscribe to the channel if you have not subscribed. So all of you, if you have not liked the session, if you have not shared it, if you have not subscribed it, do it now. Just quickly tell me what is the answer you are getting for this question. No answers. If you don't know how to solve it, just quickly tell me. I will explain. I will explain from the very basic. Don't worry. No answer. Shall I start the discussion? Shall I start the discussion? Okay. Now let us start the discussion. No problem if you are not getting it. Only one candidate is giving the answer, that is Jitendra. D option. No other candidate is giving. Only no problem. Advait Shankar is also giving us 8. Okay, just wait. You listen. You are saying voltage regulation as R per unit cos phi R plus X per unit sin phi R. And this you are saying for the lagging load condition. This is for lagging load condition. Can you help me to draw the variation of the voltage regulation with respect to the can you help me to draw the voltage regulation with respect to the load power factor angle? Yes. Can you tell me what is the value at phi r is equal to 0 degree? Can you tell me what is the voltage regulation you are getting when phi r is equal to 0? When phi r is equal to 0, cos 0 is 1, sin 0 is 0, and you are getting r per unit. You are getting r per unit as the voltage regulation. Now you put phi r is equal to 90 degree. We are trying the extreme conditions. Extreme conditions to know the nature of voltage regulation variation with respect to the load power factor angle. If you are putting phi r is equal to 90 degree, cos 90 is 0, sin 90 1, so voltage regulation is going to be x per unit. Now you tell me, if you are saying phi r 0, voltage regulation is r per unit, and if you are saying phi r is equal to 90 and you are saying voltage regulation is x per unit, now you tell me which is going to be bigger, r per unit or x per unit? Just I want this answer quickly. Just quickly answer this question. For a transmission line, I am asking you and I am quoting my words, for a transmission line, what is more? What is large? X per unit or r per unit? Just quickly tell me what is your answer. Listen very carefully. One more important concept I am going to give you. The X by R ratio of the transmission line is very high. When you say X by R ratio of the transmission line is very high, it means you say X is going to be very, very large with respect to R. It means transmission lines, load tappings are not allowed. My friend, when load tappings are not allowed, it means the resistance value is going to be very small. It is almost a conductor. You want to transmit the power. Load tappings are not allowed. You cannot connect the load to the transmission line. Are you getting this idea or not? But if you are going to the distribution line, in case of distribution line, X by R ratio is low. What is the reason? Load tappings are allowed. You can connect the load to the distribution part. Load tappings allowed. I hope you are getting your answer. The moment you are saying X by R ratio is very high for the transmission line, it means you can say that X per unit is going to be somewhere here. So X per unit somewhere here means what? X per unit somewhere here means what? Just tell me quickly. It means, my friend, and you also know that in between phi r 0 and 90, there is one angle. There is one angle, phi r is equal to theta, that is tan inverse x by r. X line upon r line. At this angle, you are getting the maximum voltage regulation. So between 0 to 90 degree, this is going to be the variation of the voltage regulation. I hope you are getting this idea. The variation of voltage regulation between 0 to 90 degree is going to be something like this. And this is the point where you are getting the maximum voltage regulation. You can understand. This is phi r is equal to theta. Now you put zero voltage regulation. When you are getting the zero voltage regulation, my friend, you are getting the zero voltage regulation for the leading load condition. So this is going to be something like that. And if you put phi r is equal to minus 90, this is lagging. And when phi r negative, then it is leading. So at this phi r is equal to minus 90, it is going to be something like this. And this is the variation of the voltage regulation. Okay. This is the value of phi r at 90 minus theta when you are getting the zero voltage regulation. And if you see this maximum value, if you put phi r is equal to minus 90 here, You will be getting minus x per unit, but you don't worry. X is never going to be negative. It is a physical phenomena. It is a physical constant. Resistance, inductance, these things, capacitance cannot be negative. Because you are using the lagging power factor formula for finding the voltage regulation, that is why you are getting minus x per unit. Because if it would have been a minus there in case of leading load condition, because for all the angles which are negative phi r, you are getting the leading load. Are you getting this? So don't worry about this minus sign. But the most important conclusion out of this variation that you can understand is, for all the lagging load condition, my friend, please understand that voltage regulation is going to be always more than R per unit. I hope you are getting this. Voltage regulation is always more than R per unit. If you come to the leading load conditions, for all the leading load conditions, my friend, you can say the voltage regulation is always less than R per unit. Now, if you have this idea in your mind, this graph is clear in your mind, almost n number of problems you can solve without even using the calculator. He is saying short transmission line has Z this much as series impedance. Which of the following voltage regulation value is possible to get at the leading power factor at full load condition? Very important, leading load voltage regulation is always going to be less than R per unit. What is R per unit? R per unit is 0.08. in percentage you can write as 8%. It means voltage regulation is always going to be less than R per unit, or you can say 8%. 20 not possible, 12 not possible, 8 not possible. D, yes, final answer. Only one candidate was able to give answer to these questions. See, even if you are not getting the answer, no problem. Before you go to the real examination, you can do n number of mistakes, no problem. But the most important thing is you make your effort. You do your part of effort that is required. Even if you fall n number of times, no problem. So now, friends, I am going to give you one important problem as homework. Just try to solve this problem as homework. I don't want this problem to be answered right now. Just do this problem and give me the answer in the comment section. All the YouTube people who are watching my session, give the answer to this question in the comment section. And in the next class tomorrow, I will take the names of those candidates who are going to give me the right answer to this questions. I hope you are getting this idea. Now, friends, let me just give you one more important information that GradeUp has recently launched the score of SSC JEE crash course for SSC JEE paper 1. You must be knowing this. If not, then you can go to the GradeUp app and you can get all the information. Right now, GradeUp is running 40% discount scholarship on the MRP to all the government engineering college students, including the diploma students, SSC JEE paper 1 qualified students. If you have any query regarding this, you can contact this number or you can mail to these email IDs. And friends, let us see who are the faculties who are going to take classes in this particular course. Manoj Singh sir, Vijay Bansal sir, Neha Joshi ma'am, Zubair Ehsani sir, all the eminent faculties are going to take classes in this. If you want to experience how GradeUp is changing the life of thousands of students, don't forget to start the free trial. That is very, very important. It is a 60-day course. The examination is between 1st of September to 4th of September. You must be aware with that. Now let us see some of the important highlights of this particular course. There is going to be 200 hours of live classes. 5,000 questions are going to be discussed in the live class. 5,000 plus questions are going to be discussed. 2,000 plus practice questions. History notes covering each topic. 20 plus subject wise and 10 full length mock tests and daily test and weekly test. The basic idea is getting your exam ready with revision. If you have any query, you can call this number and you can write your queries to these email IDs. You will be assisted in all possible manner. So thank you so much, friends, for your time. I wish you all the best. And one important point I want to tell you that I want three commitments from all of you. Number one, you have to be regular in my class if you want to get the maximum benefit out of it. You have to like this session, share this video with your friends and colleagues so that maximum people can be benefited. Okay, now some student, they were asking me, sir, you ask us to share this video, why we will be increasing the competition? Let me tell you one thing. If this would have been the case, that competition is going to be increased, one book is available to all the candidates. For example, if I take the name of P.S. Bimra, P.S. Bimra book for electrical machines, it is accessible to all the students. Why not everybody is getting selected? It is not about whether somebody is getting access to it or not. You have to make your own efforts. You have to do the self-preparation. That is very, very important. Apart from the guidance, you have to do your own hard work. Then only you can get the success. Okay, so don't think that competition is increasing. These kind of ideas are silly ideas. These are not important. And very proudly, friends, I am going to tell you that there are 60 plus students in the top 100 merit list in the Greater 2020 examination. And my friend, if you want yourself to be in this panel next year, if you want yourself to be in this panel next year, you know what you are going to do. 2021, if you want to see your photograph in this panel, what you are going to do? You are going to do the hard work. And one more thing you have to do, and that is hard work. So friends, don't forget to tell me in the comment section what is your feedback for this particular session. You can always give us your valuable feedback, and I will definitely try to cover all the important topics which are important for your examination so that your preparation must go on. Thank you so much for your time. I wish you all the best. Prep smart, score better, go greater. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, all of you. Take care of yourself. Stay safe. Stay in your home. Okay. And don't forget to join me tomorrow. Tomorrow, 8 p.m. in the evening. I want all of you to join me again. We are going to discuss a lot of interesting concepts and questions related to which topic? Medium transmission line. Tomorrow, we are going to discuss one of the most misunderstood concept of power system, that is Ferranti effect. Thank you so much for your time. All the best.